Modern and Legacy are on fire again, because every set introduces something power-crept and probably too good. But this time around, the culprit is a thing called Valky, God of Lies, and this thing isn't necessarily a card that's too powerful inherently, like the 2-mana side and the 7-mana side. Both sides are fine to good. Both could be fun cards in cube and such. But together, they're a modal spell, but still isn't too good. The problem is that when you cascade off of Ardent Plea, or off of Violent Outburst, or in Legacy Shardless Edge, and we're in Modern today, you can cascade into Valky and cast Tibalt. Yep, that's right. Cast the 3-mana Cascade spell, make a 7-mana Planeswalker, and you can do that as early as turn 1. We have things to accelerate that. So we have Gemstone Caverns. Why do I only have one Gemstone Caverns? That's weird. The version I played on stream on Monday, I'm almost certain had 3, maybe 4. Okay, we should be playing more Gemstone Caverns, I think. I guess we're not all in on the combo as such, so maybe it's not as good in a deck that wants to hit its land drops. But either way, Gemstone Cavern is a card that we can play in our opponent's turn on turn 1 if we're not on the play. After that, Spirit Guide, we can do this as early as our turn 1. We're going to cascade into Valky off of Ardent Plea. Or Violent Outburst. Ardent Plea being an enchantment version. Slightly worse for a few reasons. I mean, we get later on Exalt from it, but Violent Outburst can be done in our opponent's turn, stop them from being able to force negation it, for example. Or we do it in our opponent's end step to force them to try and counter it, then untap and go again if we've got another cascading spell. Violent Outburst is on the whole just a better card than that. And then that's our primary game plan. Our secondary game plan is, well, we've got Teferis, we've got Protection and Brazen Borrower and Bounce Spells and... Bounce Spells and Brazen Borrower and Protection and Force of Negation. And then we just have 4-0 and 2 Omnath to just go down some sort of land-based route. We have a Field of the Dead to get some Zombos. We have some other plans as well. So we can play good permission and value-based cards alongside the Valky combo. And that's it. This deck is Tibalt, Uro, Omnath. There are other versions of it. There's a Jund version that's red, black, and green, because they're the colors of Jund, obviously. That plays Blood Moon and some other like proactive things. It plays Bloodbraid Elf. That can also cascade into other cards in your deck, but... Yeah, and there are people also playing this as just a value pip in Jund, where you're just the traditional Jund mid-range deck, and this takes up the Tarmogoyf slot, I believe. So you're still playing your hand disruption and stuff. This deck isn't, like, unbeatable. We're not talking Hogak, and we're not talking Eldrazi Winter Eldrazi. It's beatable, because hand disruption can take your cascade spells away, and counter magic can play against you too, and force negation is good, and Tibalt isn't, like, backbreaking, like, the best thing ever. It's just a very, very strong early game, and it can be Brazen Borrowed or whatever, and you really want activation out of it, and so on, and so on, and so on. The problem is, don't think it's working as it really is intended. It's a little bit too good. I think it's going to warp the metagame, and whilst it's basically Living End, right? This is Living End, but you can play Omnath and Uro in it. And instead of having to like fill your yard and then cast a Cascader and then hit Living Death or Living End and then get all your bodies back, which is a thing you can interact with Ravenous Traps and, as you can see over here, and Rest in Peace and Relic and Cage and all these things that are easy to interact with. Valky does have things you can stop it with. Draenith Magistrate, or just punched my face into the mic stand, my bad. Draenith Magistrate, Thalia makes it difficult too. Trinisphere and Deafening Silence and Aether Sworn Canonist and stuff. So I guess there is interaction, but there are things that like, they don't hard shut it down when you've got Uro and Omnath as well. I don't know. It's doing well in the challenges. It's doing well in the format. Maybe it'll stabilize not to be the top deck, but I feel like it is probably too good. I am Vince, by the way, also known as Pleasant Kenobi on the internet. I'm no pro, but I do enjoy a bit of magic. If you're here, please hit that like button. Don't forget to comment down below with which point you stopped watching because you think you're better at magic than me. And if you like the cut of my GM, check me out on youtube.com/PleasantKenobi and twitch.tv/PleasantKenobi. And if you pick up anything from the Channel Fireball shop, use the code Kenobi. If you pick up a box break, for example, it's a great new way to get product without getting all the chaff. You just pick which color you want, they open the box and stream, and you get the color. It's still a little bit of a, I don't want to say, it's not a gamble. I don't want to legally say that. But yeah, there's just a bit of risk-reward in there, isn't there? A bit of risk-reward. Right, tech list is in the description below, or should be. Let's play some Modern. Okay. Our opening hand... Yeah, this is fine. We've got Uros, we've got Ardent Pleas. Like, what more could we want? We're going to put a Gemstone Caverns into play. Say okay, and ditch a Valky, I think. That means we only have 2 more Valkys left in our deck, but I think that's fine. I think that's fine. I think having 2 attempts to find Valky plus an Uro is much better. Our opponent plays a Plains. It's going to be Eighth of Isle. And we stitch up as Gift. So we're going to Hammer Time. Okay. So we know what we're up against. This is the deck that looks to play Colossal Hammer. Stick it on creatures and ruin your day. They have Lurrus in the command zone as well. They've got an Ornithopter as well. So they could go Sigarda's Aid plus Colossal Hammer next turn and hit us for a whole bunch of damage. At which point we'll have a Tibbot in play. If we draw a Simeon there, I can't even remember if we're playing Simeon this variant. Just gonna check my deck list again. Yeah, we are. Okay. Let's just go with Flooded Strand then. If we get a Tibbot, we get to exile the Ornithopter or the Copter. Sorry, the Ornithopter or the Copter, but they're the same thing. The Ornithopter or the Hammer, because Tibbot actually says exile target creature or artifact, which is quite nice. So is this a Sigarda's Aid? Just a Pure Steel Paladin, okay. So they're going for the zero equip by having metal work on the Pure Steel Paladin, which makes the hammer attach for one. We're going to kill the Paladin with our Tibbot next turn. Right, I guess we're going to grab... one of the Triomes. I don't want to say which one, because I never forget which one's which. Rorgrin's the green one, right? No, Rorgrin's the Jesko one. I guess we get Rorgrin here. Yeah, let's choose Rorgrin. We untap. We shock in a breeding pool. We go blue, white, red, Ardent Plea, Cascade. Find ourselves a Valky. Cast it as a Tibbot. Get an Ardent Plea. We'll go down take and kill the Paladin. Pass back to our opponent. Ink Moth Nexus from our opponent. If we see a Steel Shaper's Gift here, they can kill our Tibbot. We see a Stoneforge Mystic instead, which is going to get them probably not the hammer, probably a piece of utility. Because they sometimes have utility picks as well, right? Like the Elspeth's Staff. Or it might be a second hammer. Or Paradise Mantle. Paradise Mantle to up the mana count might be the line. What will they grab? Cranial Plating. Huh. Didn't actually know they played Cranial. Well, did I? I've played Hammer Time on stream. Maybe. So next time they can play Cranial Plating and equip it. But we'll have Petty Theft up available to just bounce any attacking creatures. So we're in a good spot. We're going to untap and draw another Petty Theft. We're going to tick up Tibbot to exile some cards from libraries. Oh, we've got a Pure Steel Paladin and Silent Clearing and a Watery Grave. We're going to play... Blue, green, blue. Let's play an Uro. This gains us 3 life and draws us a card. We put the Flooded Strand from our hand into play. We put the Silent Clearing from the Exile into play. And then we just pass the turn and we can just Brazen Borrow. We can Petty Theft. Colossus Hammer or an Ink Moth or an Ornithopter or whatever it is that's coming in to threaten our face or our Tibbot. Now, depending on where they're at, if they find another Pure Steel Paladin or Sigarda's Aid won't do it, but a Pure Steel Paladin, they might end up with two bodies with a Colossus Hammer and a plating on it, which means you just lose a Tibbot and take some damage. Or one of the two, sorry, and then we can Tibbot again off of the Ardent Plea next turn. So they're cracking their Marsh Flats. I guess they get a land here, a Crypt Cranial Plating to the Ornithopter, and then activate the Ink Moth at zone mana to get through for like 1, 2, 3, 3. Equip the plating to the Mystic. Balancing the Mystic is not really where we want to be, because giving them another tutor would be bad. Mystic does get in for 4 here, though. 5, actually, if they activate the Ink Moth. Comes in at Tibalt. We're going to get a basic island here. I'm going to put FF the Stoneforge because they can't recast it this turn. And that means Tibalt takes no damage. Which means he can in fact down tick on the cranial plating, interestingly. They're going to just put it on the Ornithopter? Sure. We've got to remember that Brazen Borer can't bounce the Ink Moth Nexus. That's the thing we need to keep in mind. We drew Teferi. Let's tick up Tibalt. We're basically... The thing is, when you start to tick up Tibalt, you start to get into like magical Christmas land, just doing whatever you want. It's pretty wild. Another Silent Clearing. We're going to play Teferi. Blue, white. Yeah, let's play Teferi. Let's down tick on the... On the plating, perhaps? Play a Silent Clearing. Pass back to our opponents. We have a Dismember here to kill the Ink Moth Nexus too, which is pretty huge, honestly. We're just defending ourselves until we get in an insurmountable board position. We're probably just going to be ultimating Tibalt. This is Skarner's Aid, which they should have kept the hammer in hand for. Maybe they had 2 hammers. They still should use Gift now to get a hammer. So we can Petty Theft the Sigarda's Aid, which means the hammer comes into play and doesn't do anything. That seems pretty good, doesn't it? So we Petty Theft the aid. The hammer now resolves, doesn't attach to the Ornithopter. They have 1 mana to replay the Sigarda's Aid. Fine. We untap, we draw another Teferi, so I'm just going to tick up this Teferi. Tick up. I might tick down and kill the Ornithopter. Yeah, let's do that. Play this, pay 2 life. We can cast the Ornithopter for 0. It's not terrible. We've got Flash Blockers with the Brazen Borrower. We kind of want to get to Uro Mana now, really, just to finish off this game. So let's go to Fairy, keep this one. Bounce the Scarlet, draw a card. Okay. Cast a Monkey? No, that puts our shields down on the Brazen... Well, we've got Dismember. No, I'm not going to go shields down just yet. But I can flash in the Brazen Borer as a threat anyway. I think I might have missed a point. Did I have mana for Brazen Borer in the last 2 turns? I don't think I did. Should we play their Pure Steel, steal their Colossus Hammer, and just like equip to our own thing and really go ham? That'd be pretty fun. Memnite from our opponent. Sigarda's Aid from our opponent. Stoneforge Mystic from our opponent, I assume. They get a third hammer now. The thing I'm finding with this deck, at least I haven't played a load yet into all these matchups, is that I'm not sure how I finish off matches quite like I can. I just feel like I'm fumbling around, like living my best life, but not really getting there very quickly. End of turn, we're going to flash in a Brazen Borrower. Untap. Draw an Ardent Plea. Tick up our Tibble. Make ourselves some more cards. Got a Force of Negation there as well. Cast an Ornithopter. We want to keep Dismember up, don't we? I guess we Ardent Plea and exile one of their bodies. That seems reasonable. Yeah, cast this Tibalt. Keep the new one. Resolve the Ardent Plea. Then we're just going to go exile. The Stoneforge. Cool. Play a Temple Garden, don't pay life for it. And then we're going to go for 5 in the air with double Exalted. Play a fetch land. Activate the Ink Moth Nexus. Yeah, okay. Play a Stoneforge. Sure. Get a Colossal Hammer, sure. Crack their Heath, sure. So they're going to play the Hound and try and put on the Ink Moth, and I'm just going to dismember the Ink Moth. They won't have any mana to protect it with any random protection spells they might be playing. I've seen people play Apostle's Blessing, I think it is, in this deck. I don't like it. Cast here. Black. Colorless and black. Oh, I should have let this resolve and put the trigger onto it, to be honest. That's what I should have done. That was a mistake. Yeah, that was definitely a mistake, because now they've got one equipped. That was silly of me. I mean, we can have Chumpers for days. That's an 11-11. Now all they need is a... Thingamabob of the thing that gives trample on lifelink. Yeah, that's a mistake. Okay, they should have kept going here because they could. I think they should have kept going. Post board, I guess we want Supreme Verdict. Dismember and Fire Spouts. Do we even want Fire Spouts? It doesn't kill anything with a hammer attached to it. But then arguably, neither does Dismember. We probably want Force Negations on the draw. To be able to counter like a clutch hammer. I'll bring on one Fire Spouts. Yeah, we probably want some number of the Force Negations just to counter clutch hammers, basically. Like, so if they have a really good turn two and we have like sat there with one land in play, we can Force Negation the hammer and therefore just pick apart their entire plan with one small part of permission. I think is where we want to be. Okay. Well, this seems reasonable. We do need a third land, though. Yeah, it's fine. We'll draw another land. No third land, no Force of Negation, no Dismember, no Brazen Borrower. This hand probably isn't good. But... I have no buts. There's literally nothing. I have nothing to add. Hopefully we'll draw a Simeon Spirit Guide in our next two draws. That'd be... Gas. This cigar is Aiden. I had a viewer send me a ton of cigar is Aiden back in the day. I wonder if it was the person who ever like invented this deck. trying to get me to play it more back then. Who knows? So they had 4 cards in hand. I think they mulled to 6. 4 cards after the draw from the bauble. Let's go Strand. We can go get a Triome with that. Probably get the Ketria, whichever one has the green on it. Pure Steel, sure. Next turn they can play a Cantripping Hammer. They could go Double Hammer and just kill us. Yeah, probably maybe we'll draw Force Negation. Maybe we'll draw Dismember. So Dismember, Force Negation, and Brazen Bora and Simeon Spirit Guide are all good here. Grab Ketria so we have access to green. Untap. Drew Field of the Dead. Not good. Okay, let's play Field of the Dead. If they have Double Hammer, we die. If they have Hammer plus Land plus Cranial Plating, we don't die. So they still ship us for a Hammer here. And they get to hit us for 12. It's a lot, my friends. It's a lot. Okay. We're going to get 12'd. Let's draw a card here. Oh, if they hit another land. Though, no. Because if they had a hammer in hand, they would have cast the hammer in hand to try and hit the second land, right? Paying costs. Nothing. Okay, they went to pay costs there. Guess they've got a mana on the Pure Steel Paladin. We untap. We draw this. We pay 2 life. Can't cast Ardent Plea because my mana is bad. We're going to get Violent Outburst. God. Glad we got that. Cascade. Hit a Valky. Cast the Tibalt. Excel the Pure Steel Paladin. Gives us a blocker next turn if we... If we hit another land, we can go Pure Steel plus the Brazen Borer, I guess. Thought sees me. Okay. My mana is generally awful right now. I've just realized getting the Rorgrim Triome to enable to Uro meant we didn't get mana for any of these white spells. But that said, Uro gains us life and draws us a card, which is probably better than the rest of it. No, I guess that's a fairy bounce is better if they take the Brazen Borer here and play a Memnite, we could be in trouble. They took the Ardent Plea. They don't want to give us a second Tibalt. Still Shaper's Gift. Yeah, we definitely should have got Rorgrim Triome. The green wasn't important. The white was important. Swift for boots from our opponent. Oof, okay. They can hasty out of nowhere. I don't like that. We have to keep Brazen Borer up without a doubt. We're going to uptick Tibalt. Draw 2 cards. One from our library, one from their library. Find a Silent Clearing. That's a white spell. White source for white spell, should I say. Let's go Snow-Covered Forest, tap these for a Pure Steel Paladin, because you can pay any mana type for the stuff exiled. And then we've still got access to a Brazen Borrow as well. Or a Petty Theft, should I say. So we can take the boots off pre-combat in the beginning combat phase, you see. Swiftfoot boots, okay. The Hexproof is better than Shroud, so they're better than Lightning Goose in that deck, because you can still equip equipment when you're Hexproof. You can't still equip equipment when you're Shroud. I I think I want a Brazen Borrower bounce that now. No, we want to keep Brazen Borrower up at all times. Exile cards on top of libraries. What do we find? Thoughtseize. Valky. If they had a creature, they would have played it, right? So I don't think Valky's going to hit the creature that we need to hit. Oh, they've given up. We've got to piece together and be a little bit careful not to throw the game as they almost did in the last one. But they've given up. They're just like, sure, you got me. You got a Tibble. You got me. We have lost the die roll. Magic the Gathering is a difficult game. We have a turn one Tibalt. We're going to keep this. Because we're not on the... we're on the draw. So we get a Gemstone Caverns. We have Simian Spirit Guide as well. That's Gemstone Caverns. Okay. Do I want to ditch an Omnath? I don't want to ditch an Omnath, right? I want to ditch... Do I ditch a land? Because Tibalt will get us lands. That's rough if they counted a Tibble or anything, right? I'll ditch the Omnath. Doesn't feel right, but... Because Omnath is just so much value. Like, such huge amounts of value. Opponent goes City of Brass. So they're on, like, the Tibble Trickery deck, perhaps? Either that or Dredge, right? Or maybe Ad Nauseam. They're the three City of Brass decks off the top of my head. Cool. Let's go Temple Garden. Pay the life. Go green, green, red. Violently outburst ourselves. Do they have a response? Nope. Let's make a Tibble. I guess if we exile cards on top of both our libraries, we get to understand where they're at. They are playing Branchway, Bark Channel Pathway, the green-blue pathway. Oh, we should ditch that land. Should have known we'd hit lands with the Tibalt. That is interesting. The green-blue pathway. I've seen the green-white pathway played in D&T a little bit. I think all the pathways are, you know, moderately playable in Modern anyway. They didn't hit a second land, so we actually got the land top somehow. Ooh, rough. We untap. We tick up Tibble. We find a Veil of Summer. We're going to play the pathway on green. No, we need a black mana. Let's have a look at their hand with Valky. Just realized we had black mana because the gemstone mark. I always think it doesn't give you multiple. I know it gives you five color, but I also feel like you use the counter and then you get five color afterwards. And that's obviously not the case. At least this way around, we got Veil of Summer up in case they've got like a push in hand or some nonsense. They're thinking long and hard about us casting this Valky. Maybe it's whether they want to scoop and not let us see the information of their hand. Because so far we've seen a Veil of Summer and two lands. I'm assuming there's some sort of combo deck. Oops or spells would make sense to the City of Brass. Yeah, they're Neoform. They're literal Neoform. Scary. They could still win. They could still win if they hit another land. Okay. Is Neoform good against Tibalt? That's an interesting one. So the hand was Manalfoes, Summoner's Pact, Neoform, Summoner's Pact. So they can Summoner's Pact for a Allosaurus, a Rider, and Neoform on the same turn. I guess you want to... I don't know, how do you beat that? Draw another Violent Outburst, okay. Pick up Tibble. Find a Pact of Negation, which we can pay for in the following turn. almost. Oh yeah, well the Simmons Spirit Guard we can, but we can't use the mana from it, unfortunately. Okay. Gotta dodge the anger for one more turn. Let's go with Ketria Triome Tapped. No, we need to play the Simian Spirit Guide, I think. Let's go Misty Rainforest. Let's cast this Simian Spirit Guide. Yeah, we need to get on the aggro plan. The aggro 2-2s and 2-1 plan. Because the lower their life total, the less likely they are to pop off because they won't be able to draw so many cards of Grizzlebrand when they neo-form an Allosaurus Rider into a Grizzlebrand. And we also have access to Velocimon, but it doesn't really do a lot against them. It does protect our pact from their pact if they've drawn a pact in the meantime. We get to veil their pact when they pact our pact when they go off, for example. Okay. Do they draw the Simian Spirit Guide or the necessary land? I guess Bark Channel Pathway might be just be better than a lot of the lands you'd normally play in Neo form. Go grab a Triome. Not the Ketria though, let's go grab Rorgrin. We need a Force Negation in hand, really. Teferi's pretty good. Let's exile cards from libraries again. Find a Nourishing Shoal. Play a Teferi. Blue, white, and a black mana. Play a Tarn. Tick up Teferi. Attack them for 4. Down to 14, and they don't have access to that Nourishing Shoal in their hand now. We could exile the Violent Outburst to the Nourishing Shoal to gain the life we need. We have access to Pact of Negation now, so I don't think they can win. They found a Simian Spirit Guide. They're making red-white. They're going to Metamorphose to draw a card. Sure. They're going to Summoner's Pact. Sure. I'm going to counter the Allosaurus Rider. There's a fear they get another land plus a Vela somewhere in amongst all this. That's the real fear, I guess. They cast the Allosaurus Rider. I'm going to allow them to cast Neoform, I think. Yeah, then we're just going to pack the negation. I'm going to crack this and make sure I can get a mana that's going to be untapped next time. Probably going to grab a Breeding Pool here. Or was that exiled? That is exiled. This takes us off green. Oh no, we can cast Velocimon regardless, can't we? Let's grab Scene Vents. Pay the life. Then we're going to Pact of Negation the Neo form. And if they have Veil of Summer, we're fine. Next time we're paying 5 mana to not lose the game. Okay, cool. They've seen enough. We're against Neo form. So I guess Mystical Dispute's pretty good against Neo form itself, right? So we want those. Brazen Borrowers, you can bounce the Grizzlebrand, but it doesn't seem hot. Dismember is also bad. Let's go with that. I think we're just far more consistent than even Neobrand Neoform combo is. And I love me a bit of Neoform combo. But we just get to... This deck is dumb. This deck is so dumb. I want to know in the comment section below how you feel about all this existing, you know? I do think the Cascade rule needs to change. I really do. It'd be better for future design space around mono double face cards and other mechanics they might want to explore, right? Things similar to the split cards and the Aftermath and all that stuff. I know Aftermath cards were never broken with this mechanic, but I mean, you know, in future there could be something similar that would be. We have two mana. We're one white, one green source off of casting one of these. We have a blue source and a Mystical Disputes. If they turn one combo us, we're dead. If they turn two combo us, we're dead. Because this is tapped. I'm going to risk this. Because we might just draw an untapped blue source, and then we've just got Mystical Dispute up, and then we can combo them on turn three. Still be turn three because this is tapped, so. Chancellor of the Tangle. Oh, whoa there. Okay, that is a spanner in the works of this hand. Okay, we need to find ourselves some untapped lands, and soon. We did not. Okay, pass turn. So they have five cards in hand, one of which is Chancellor of the Tangle. Pathway, sure. They got two mana there. So our Mystical Dispute is... Oh, I'm an idiot. I'm thinking Chancellor of the Annex. I was literally sat here thinking, oh, it's going to cost me one. Need to draw another land. We don't. We actually do get to untap and have Mystical Disputes. That's good. They might be waiting for three mana so they can have Veil alongside it. I would love to just like pop off here. That'd be lovely. Nope. Okay. Still a land away from Tybalting. But we do have Dispute. We're going to discard Uro. Because we can cast him later. Hope of Giropa, eh? That stops our Dispute pretty bad. Well, as of next turn, anyway. Okay, let's find ourselves a Tibble. Oh, mana. Land? A land? No. A third Mystical Dispute. Wow, we are one land away from just being godlike over here. Hope of Giropa has strong... what's the swarm? Xanthid Swarm? Xanthid Swarm, yeah. It's got an Ardent play. Metamorphose, okay. I'm glad they're doing this in their main phase, because if they're trying to get towards Neoform, we actually have access to Dispute here. Okay, I'm just going to hit us with Hope of Giropa. Oh my goodness, just one land, even one Simeon? No, one Simeon doesn't cut it. Discard Cryptic. Maybe holding Cryptic in hand, discarding Mystical Dispute would be better, but there's Metamorphose, okay. Trying to hit that third land, perhaps. Double green, okay. A white source or a green source. So actually, white or green. We could draw our basic islands and not get there. That's pretty funny. That is legitimately quite funny. Take one here. Okay, until the next turn, target player, until your next turn. So we can't cast anything in our turn. That's fine. They're just trying to stop us from combat. Okay, so we've got access to a breeding pool or a triome or whatever here, but we can't cast anything in our turn. But we can Mystical Dispute in their turn. And we've got double Mystical Dispute if we fetch an untapped land, like a Steam Vents, for example. And we don't want to get a Steam Vents. We want to get a Hallowed Fount. No, we want to get Temple Garden. We're going to get Temple Garden. Do we have Temple Garden in our deck? I believe we've got Temple Garden in our deck. Alistar's Rider resolves. Three mana for the evolution. Okay. We're going to have to. We're going to have to use our Simian Spirit Guide to Mystical Dispute this. Otherwise, we're just losing the spot. So we're going to grab Temple Garden. Pay the life. Green, blue, exile this, mystical dispute this. Would it cost us one if it was Neoform? Cost us three because the Eldritch Evolution. You have to pay three. They got two cards in hand, so they can't have three Simian Spirit Guides. They've already used one. And they couldn't have had Velasum because they have their mana. And they couldn't have had, well, they could have had a Pact of Negation, but it would have been bad. Okay, that's good. We got them down to two cards in hand. We're now alive to any untapped land. We didn't draw an untapped land, which is fine. We have two more Mystical Disputes against Neoform anyway. It's bad against Allosaurus Rider into land Allosaurus Rider Eldritch Evolution again. If that's what they're stuck on. Okay, land. What a weird game of Magic. Flooded Strand. Now, if we just tap out, we might be in trouble. So I'm going to wait a turn. Valky next turn or in their end step. And that allows us to get a land into play off of the Valky, the Tybalt activation, which allows us to get Mystical Dispute and passing back. Get a red Triumph with this. Can we get the Jeskai? No, we get the Rorgrin one, the green one. Is Rorgrin green? I've said it three times now. I'm sure Rorgrin should be green. Is Ketria green or Rorgrin's Jeskai? And by green, I mean rug. Green base. Okay, they've given up. Oh, modern. Once again, we have not won the die roll, but we do have a turn to Tybalt. So we're going to keep this. We have a Skeleton Tarn to get a Triome on turn one. Turn two, go Snow Covered Island, take no damage, and make a Tybalt. Or do something else, obviously, depending on what our opponent does. If they thought Seize our Ardent Plea, for example, we still have like actual cards and how they do things. We drew a Gemstone Mines, we place Skeleton Tarn and pass the turn to our opponent. Our Tarn has to get something blue, which is pretty difficult not to do in our deck because we don't actually have access to a basic mountain or Stomping Grounds or any of that crap. Okay, Tyler Skull can take Ardent Plea to stop us Tybalting. We can take Teferi to stop us Teferiing them. Yeah, there's a lot of options here. We kind of need a green mana for when we draw green spells. But I also want a black mana to cast Loki. Valky. Key thing is Loki. It's obviously the stand-in, the proxy. I'm going to grab the green-based Triome. I believe that's Ketria. Oh, I'm learning. Untap. Draw a Mystic Sanctuary. Pass the turn to our opponent. I think considering they appear to be Death and Taxes, Valky probably was a good shout. Like, if they went Leon and Arbiter plus Goose Quarter here, I guess we could pay for it with the Simian Spirit Guide, but it wouldn't be good. Thought sees me. Okay. So Dead Guy Ale, White-Black D&T, or the Dead Guy Ale port to modern. White-Black D&T with Thought Seize. Old school tokens. Is Abzan mid-range? We haven't seen the green yet. There's a lot of questions and not many answers. Concealed Courtyard, okay. They took the Teferi from our hand because the only thing in hand currently deals with the Tide Hollow Skull. That makes perfect sense. Stoneforge, Mystic. Yeah, would love to have Valkyried that away. What are you going to get, my friend? What are you going to get? Fire and Ice? Just Batterskull? Feast and famine. Wow, 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 wow. Okay. We want to find just a thing to cascade into. Cascade here. Like any cascade card would be real good. That is not a cascade card. They're going to go land, activate, make the Sword of Feast and Famine, apply it to the Tower of the Scholar and attack us. It's going to discard a card and... Do we play a Simeon Spirit Guide just to block it? That seems terrible. Might be where we're at, though. Because otherwise we're just discarding something anyway, and them untapping to then play like another threat to follow up with the Tower of the Scholar carrying the sword is not good. If they don't hit the fourth land, we've been rewarded. Because so far this game hasn't gone our way at all. Don't they hit the fourth land? Okay. Marsh Flats. Make a sword. Equip the sword. Attack us. We're going to block. So we won't want any of our backup plans here. We want to draw like... Well, we don't want to draw... we don't want to draw Omnath, but like drawing Uros would be great. Drawing lands is not the best. Let's look at the two cards in their hand. Hopefully it's something real good that we can take away. Skyclave. It's almost really good. So close to being really good. Okay, take the Skyclave. Just stops them from like Skyclaving our Valky next turn. God, Skyclave is so good. At least we can transform Valky into a Skyclave to block the Tidehawk next turn, but then that puts the Skyclave back in their hand. Alright, it doesn't consume it or anything. Ugh. Stoneforge. Grit Bataskull. Oh god, they're gonna get a Maul, aren't they? And then they're gonna activate their Stoneforge, put it onto this Tidehawk Scholar, and create an absolute monster of a creature. So we want to cascade into Tybalt. Kill a Scholar. And then Mystic Sanctuary, one of the spells back onto our land. No, they just got Fire and Ice. Just going to get Fire and Ice. Okay, okay, okay. That is a thing, I guess. I guess Brazen Borrower to bounce the Tower of the Scholar as they go to equip the Fire and Ice would be pretty hot. Oh, they had to equip it this turn. Okay, it's got Pro Red and Pro Black now, so Tybalt can't even kill this Tower of the Scholar. We can't bounce it with Brazen Borrower. I guess cascading the Tybalt, exile path to the top of their library, path their Tidehawk Scholar. That's certainly a line. So as you can see, this deck we're playing is actually a little bit soft to both, well, things that can't be killed or blocked by black creatures, it seems, but also hand attack. Like, Tidehawk Scholar follow up with Thoughtseize was good enough to stop us really getting anywhere. They're going to eat our Strand, which draws them a card, right? Third Stoneforge Mystic, okay. Bataskull, well, sure. I mean, to add insult to injury, that is fine. We drew another land. Okay. We can transform Valky into a Skyclave and block the Tidehawk Scholar, so we're not discarding, taking damage, or letting them untap. Which gives us a turn to try and draw something that matters. And honestly, I don't really know what this deck can do now that matters at this point. Mm-hmm. I guess it is the Tebow into path line, right? That is all we got. That's all we got. Turn to a white 2/2. Take 3 going to 7. The pathfinder isn't good enough now, right? Because they've got so many swords they can just make anybody on the board a threat. It's a lot of lands. That's a lot of lands. Supreme Verdict, Timely, Dismember, Double Spouts, and a Brazen Borrower. Yeah, that seems alright, doesn't it? I'm going to cut the Crypt. Nah, Cryptic's pretty good. Let's cut Force of Negation, actually. It doesn't seem very good against them. Guess 2 Teferis as well. Let's go with that. Yeah, because Teferi bouncing equipment's just not good. And against Fire and Ice, it's even worse as it can't bounce the creature, it's got to bounce the equipment. I guess bouncing the equipment and forcing it on the way back down isn't the worst thing in the world, but that said, oh, balls. We don't want to do that. We want to do that. We don't really want to be doing that anyway, because it's like a bounce that thing, draw a card, then we pitch a card to get rid of it, and then we've, like... I guess the Force of Negation is free. It's better than bouncing and trying to cryptic all the way back down. But as you can tell from my ramblings and my bumbling around it, I don't think it's good. I don't think that's good. I guess there's an argument for is a Force better than Teferi? Probably not. The scary thing about any white hate bear-esque deck like Death and Taxes when you're playing a deck like this is like, what have they got on their sideboard? Aether Sworn Canonists? Eidolons of Rhetoric? Deafening Silence? Like, there's a lot of stuff that could really ruin us. This is a no-go. This hand doesn't do anything. This hand has Ardent Plea. And it's a fairy. Already said these aren't good. I'm going to keep this and ship the Snow-Covered Plains because I don't want to go to a 6/5. And maybe, just maybe, that was wrong. Let's go Misty Rainforest, pass the turn to our opponent. If they have Thoughtseize, they take the Ardent Plea. Inquisition, take the Ardent Plea. Should have mulled to 5. Should have mulled to 5. Because Teferi just isn't good. I've just explained that to you, how bad Teferi actually is. Play a Triome, pass to our opponent. I guess we get to like bounce their Stoneforge Mystic now, or get eaten up by a Tidehollow Scholar. They're the two like most common lines here from our opponent. Okay, we're gonna draw a Dismember, or we're gonna draw a Cascader, and every time we touch, I get this feeling. Grab a snow-covered island. Find a dismember off this Uro, that'd be nice. I mean, Violent Outburst isn't bad either. It's whether they have a second Tidehollow Scholar now. Which would be so bad. It would be so bad for us. We're 2 cards away from having Uro back into play. Don't forget, we saw our opponents playing main board Cling to Dust. They could just like go get a Stoneforge and cling our Uro here. Thoughtseize plus Cling would probably be the... That is basically Thoughtseize here. Hand Attack plus Cling would be the most brutal turn. So we've seen the Hand Attack. If we draw a fetch land, we can not cast... Uro, because I didn't fetch into double green. If we draw a fetch, we can get a green source. Yeah, that's fine. Dark Confidant. Okay, I'm okay with that. I'm okay with that. Take two here, sure. Untap and draw an Omnath. Red. No. White. No, we can't. Red. White, red. No green. Oh, no green. Well, we have green, but we don't have green and red and white. How can our mana base be so greedy and so bad? Okay, let's pass to our opponent. Our deck is kind of falling apart here, right? Okay, so there's the needle for the Tybalt. That's fine. We have an Omnath Uro game plan. Need a second green source. Also feel that it might just be good enough against them if they don't get the sword online. Oh my goodness. Why did I say it out loud? Guild of Gurin, comment section. I talk about how the field might just be enough. And they draw a deafening silence. Wow, okay. Silence, Guild of Gurin, and Pithing Needle. Okay. Pithing Needle, for those pedantic enough to correct pronunciations in the chat. Ugh, jeez. Our deck could not be performing any worse. Which happens, right? Like, as we saw in the first two games, the deck wasn't even remotely fair for our opponents. So sometimes it will just fold in itself and collapse under the weight of a weak mana base. And that might just be why the Jund version is better, because the mana is more consistent. And also the Blood Moon punishes the opposing Cascade Tybalt decks. Needle naming Tybalt. Fine, fine, fine. We just need to draw a green source or a dismember or the bouncy bounce bounce spell. So we can go bounce the Tartarus Skull on our turn, play the Teferi, bounce the Deafening Silence. If we draw the sixth land, then cast Outburst, then get Tybalt. But it's too late because they've now got Needle and Tybalt too. We're going to take four here. It might be worth just getting ourselves a Valky off the Vine Outburst. Oh, we can't, because Deafening Silence, we can't do it. We drew a Valky, though. What could they have in hand that they haven't cast? Nothing good, right? Tide Hollow Sculler? Sure. There's double Lily in hand! Double Lily in hand. I can't actually believe it. We're just dead, right? There's nothing we can do against Deafening Silence, Field of Ruin, Pithing Needle, Liliana. That's really funny. They hit another Tide Hollow. Ah, do you know what? Okay, cool, 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 cool. We can't beat that. Let's go to the next round. I'm firmly tilted. It's not worth the time. Okay, we failed to go first again. Which is quite impressive, actually, to go... We haven't gone 50-50 yet. We're going to mulligan this. Doesn't do anything. We're going to keep this because it does things. We're going to bottom the Triome. Keep the three action spells, three lands. I mean, you can't complain. If you start with three lands or three action spells with most decks in most formats, you wouldn't mind, right? You just wouldn't mind. Our opponent has kept a seven, of course. Oh no, you. I'm going to blow a kiss. That could be that they like me and they don't like the stuff I play. That could be that they don't like me and they don't like the stuff I play. Could be that they just hate me, which is fine. It's fine. There's a lot of people that just seemingly hate me. And I've come to terms with it. I've come to terms with it, you know? Right. Let's beat Elves or Ponza. Not too sure. Okay, we have the turn two Ardent Plea. the turn two Ardent Plea. So get a Hallowed Fountain with this or the White Triome. I'm going to say Rorgrin, but I mean, this is the fourth round now, and I still haven't figured out which one's which. There's just no way of really knowing. You could read the cards and learn them, but there's no way of really knowing. Utopia Sprawl onto the Forest. Attack for one? Okay. White, red, and blue. Yeah, we've got another fetch land for a green source. Untap, play this, exile this, cast this. Cascade, make a Tibalt, kill the Arboroth. And immediately for Violet, you don't disappoint now, do you? Oh, that was like the blowing a kiss. Winks. Right. On plea resolves. Nothing personal, kid. We're going to kill the Arboroth just because of the ramp it provides them. Because they get to untap this Utopia Sprawl and get like 4 mana next turn. This gives them access to 2 here in their in our end step. Maybe to cycle a cycling land. Shield Thicket, green, red. What is this going to be? Stomp the Tibalt. Nah, that's fair. That's fair. Arboroth is dead. Pass back to our opponent. They play a third land. I guess they could just play Bone Crusher Giant here. We can slam Uro next turn. Blood Moon. Well, at least we can bounce with the Brazen Borer. At least we can bounce with the Brazen Borer. I guess Blood Moon is really good right now because the mana bases are so, like, unbelievably bad. Or greedy, should I say. Let's go Snow-Covered Plains. Make an Arbor Elf. How is this still a Plains? That shouldn't be a Mountain Plains. That should just be a Plains. Then we just want to draw another Cascade spell and bounce the Blood Moon post. Pre in their end step. Pre that. Blood Braiding into Tibalt. Is that where this is at? No, they hit an Arbor Elf. What if Ponza could do that? Yeah, that's a Ponza deck in itself, right? Attack for 3? Sure. Untap and draw a Misty. We're just going to flood now, aren't we? I mean, I can't say I'm not used to it. I say that, we've only had one game in this league where I flooded, but it was the one that we played the longest, because all the other games are so quick. That's the problem with this deck as well, I guess, is that when you win, it's quick, and when you lose, it's not, even unless your opponent's on the same deck. I mean, that's Magic in general. Maybe everyone should just play very fast combo decks, and everyone would be happy, because the games go quickly. I just think I'll block to conserve life here. Kill their Arbor Elf. Take 3, they play a Bone Crusher. They play a Chandra. Wow, 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 wow. Okay. 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 Bone Crusher Giant, there it is. What do we find? Okay, we've got the ability. We've got the ability. We have the technology. We're gonna take 6 this turn. Probably 7, 8, thanks to Chandra. Then we get to make a Tibalt in their turn and hope it's good enough, and it's just not going to be. So we're dead, right? 8, 9, say 8, 11, 12, 13. Yeah, we're dead. We're dead. Well, unless we bounce one now. We cascade into a Valky to block. Bounce this. We can also block with the Brazen Borer here. Although we have to take a bunch to do so. We have to take two here. Oh my god, do we go to... Oh, we can't do it. We can't do it. We don't have enough untapped lands. Is that what the problem is here? Because we're taking seven. So you have to shock ourselves down to eight. Yeah, that's the only way, right? I mean, this could be an untapped land, but it takes us to seven. And we're getting hit by four, four, and three. Also, fun fact, whilst thinking about those numbers, didn't even fetch a green source. That should have been a breeding pool. Cool. Okay. Go to sideboarding. Bring in another Brazen Borrower. Bring in some Core Firewalkers. Are they even good? Are they even good? Because you cascade into them, and I think it's good against Burn and Blitz, right? Blitz primarily, but Burn with your Play Against on Monday night. Is it good against Ponza? If all their threats are red, they're going to struggle to kill. They can't kill them. They categorically cannot kill them. No, they're not good, are they? They're not good. We can force the Blood Moon. We can bounce the Blood Moon. We can counter the Blood Moon. We can even play around and through a Blood Moon. Thanks to the use of this piece of tech called a basic forest. We do have one, right? Yeah. Let's prioritize those then. I'd love to play first. Keep. This is pretty good. We have Force Negation plus Ardent Plea. Uro as a backup plan. Violent Outburst as the actual plan. They probably got... But do you reckon they're going to Trinisphere's post-board? I would assume not. I would assume not. Rorgrin Triome. Pass to our opponent. They get turn one Double Simeon Blood Moon. We get to force it, so we're not too bad about not fetching basics with our Misty and our Scalding Tarn. Foothills into Forest into Arboreal Utopia Spool, I assume. Needle. We're going to be forcing that bad boy and we're going to ditch Uro to do so. So that means our Tibalt. We've got an uphill struggle. We drew a Simeon Spirit Guide. So we're going to go... get a Forest. Red, red, green, red, Vine Outburst. I'm glad to bring my Core Firewalkers in, aren't you? God, that'd be awful here. Get an Emblem, resolve the Vine Outburst. Next two cards, what do we get? Utopia Sprawl. Sure. It's time to kill our opponent with their deck again, hopefully. Arbor Elf, sure. Windswept Teeth, sure. We untap. We draw a Brazen Borrower. We play the Tarn, which we shouldn't have done, honestly. We crack this. We grab a basic island. And we cast Utopia Spawn onto this. Actually, you know what? No. Let's tick up our Tibalt. Yeah, let's tick up our Tibalt. Force of Negation, Brazen Borrower in hand, Needle. Let's cast Needle. Let's name. Do I name Windswept Teeth or Arbor Elf here? Windswept Teeth. I reckon. We don't have one in hand, they have one in play. Yeah, let's name Winds of Teeth. Cool, we can't activate that. Then we're going to go blue Utopia Sprawl on my forest. As the battle, I'm going to name blue. Cool. I think we play like one or two heaths, but I don't really care. Next turn, I'll probably just eat the Arbor. If they found a Stomping Grounds, they got three mana here. Blood Moon. Sure. End of turn, we just put it back in the hand. We untap. We draw Uro. We exile the Arbor Elf. And this give it up. Cool. Okay. So get Arbor Elf, land from exile, keep Force up for the Blood Moon. Play the Uro. Use the Ardent for the Force, I think. Fire Spouts kills Bloodbraid Elf, Arbor Elf. Doesn't kill the Giant. Oh, it does kill the Giant. It's a 4-3, isn't it? And we can cast it through Blood Moon. Probably better than both those Teferis, honestly. I could be. Did I bring Supreme Verdict in? Why would I bring it? Okay, ignore it. Pretend you didn't see that. Okay, we're going to go turn two, Ardent Plea. And we can fetch basic island, basic... Yeah, we can fetch basic. So let's go keep. We'll go turn two, Valky, turn three, Ardent Plea. Gemstone Caverns, say okay. Exile Mystic Sanctuary. Sprawl, sure. Now if they have Blood Moon, we can't. Well, we can get a basic island, right? So I can Valky them here to take like, I don't know, Bloodbraid Elf or whatever. We can get a basic island anyway. So we can just bounce the Blood Moon. Yeah. Oh no, I wanna get a basic planes here, don't I? But I can't bounce the Blood Moon next turn. We just get an island and keep it up. They mulliganed hard. They're on two cards in hand. I still got the plane still because the cavern makes the blue. I can float it. Oh, that's funny. Crack the heath. Play a Blood Moon. I bounce an end step, untap, make a Tybalt. Seems pretty decent. Put another Sprawl. Okay, then cast a Blood Moon. Three mana to go. Red and red. I want a Ghost Quarter. That'll blow that up, honestly. I can't bounce the land, unfortunately. Okay. Simeon Spirit Guide. Let's go ahead and go Tarn. Crack it. Should have got basic planes. I messed up real bad there like an idiot. Let's get a Breeding Pool and say yes. Let's go white, green, blue. Cast Ardent Plea. They have one card in hand. Cascading. They skew it up. Okay. I was thinking through a lot of stuff that I didn't need to when they multiplied. In an historic event, I've won the die roll. So we had 2 out of 5. And as the queen used to say, 2 out of 5 ain't bad. This hand, they got Lurrus. We've got a turn two Ardent. We've got Force. This is some good stuff. This is some good stuff. Now the Lurrus, so I'm not so scared of Blood Moon. That'd be so funny if they end up being a Blood Moon deck. So I think I'm going to play this first, going to get a Triome. I'm going to get the... Well, we've got white there. We've got green there too. Either the Triomes make red. I've got red in hand. So yeah, I'm going to grab a Triome, I think. We don't want to yield to anything. Let's go Scald and Tarn. Pass to them. Got good old Force of Negation up. Some wonderful artwork, honestly. It's one of my favorite counter spells. It really, really embodies the idea of like protecting yourself against the oncoming onslaught of a Haymaker spell or a combo finish. Flavor Text, try if you must. Not so keen on, but I do like the art. I like the art a lot. So shout out to Paul Canavan. Jace's Phantasm. We're against Mill? They're going to, like, archive trap me when I do this? Hit all three of our Tibalts? let's get Ketria or Rorgrin. What's the upside downside? Let's get Ketria. Makes a blue, right? Yeah. It's the rug one, Vince. Ketria and Rorgrin. There we go. As long as we hit all our Tibalts, we're fine. It hit one of them. Did it hit an Uro? God damn it, didn't even hit that. Never mind. Okay. They could kill us real fast if we're not careful. Cool. Blue, white, and red. Cast an Ardent Plea. Cascade. Cast Tibble. We just now rather than later. Resolve the Plea. Down, tick the Tibalt, eat the Jace's Phantasm. To protect the Tibalt. Next turn we can go Teferi. Or we can just keep Teferi in chamber to fuel the Force of Negation, honestly. Jace's Phantasm number two. Okay. It's a 5-5. Just a casual 5-5. Two Jace's Phantasms. Not ideal. So we can bounce one with Teferi. Let's uptick Tibalt and see what we find. Two Jace's Phantasms. Okay. We're going to go... Phantasm number one. Phantasm number two. Misty Rainforest. And now we can block their Phantasms for a turn. Next turn we can go Jace bounce one, Tibalt eat the other. I guess them going to the bin means they can just lure us them back, which is kind of terrifying. If this is a glimpse of the unthinkable, we're going to have to Fatal Push my Phantasm. This protects my... Tibalt here. Okay. Let's Force Negate the Fatal Push. They come into attack. If they come in my face, I might let them through. No, both are Tibalt. Blocking. Don't you want to draw another way to get rid of one of these Jace Phantasms? What do we draw? Mystic Sanctuary. Okay. So we can put something on top of our library. Exile it with Tibalt. We need to hit something with this uptick of the Tibalt, don't we? We really do. Let's go... Exile top cards of our libraries. Find Glimpse the Unthinkable and Omnath. We're going to lose Tibalt. That's fine. That's fine. So we've got red, white, green, and blue. So shock ourselves... Go and grab a basic forest. Cast this beautiful, beautiful Omnath. Draw a card. Okay, so we've got Tybalt again next turn. They have to swing both Phantasms into Tybalt to kill him. They might just put Lurrus and Hank, there's so many Phantasms in the bin. This is an interesting game of Modern. I'm playing a dumb deck. They're playing Phantasm Mill Lurrus? Varg? I'm here for it. I'm here for it. Maybe we should go basic. And then we got Hallowed Fountain to turn the Mystic Sentry on next turn. So they kill Tybalt here. That's my dog getting very excited for dinner. Or do they go face? Do they go face? No, they hit Tybalt for one. No, they kill Tybalt. They kill Tybalt. Okay. Tybalt is dead. There's one Tybalt left in our deck for our Violent Outburst. Do they put Lurrus in hand here? So we're going to Violent Outburst into Tybalt and kill a Phantasm. Trophy me. Do I search? Probably not. Let's say... Oh god, they're going to archive trap me, aren't they? Oh, I don't even have a land. Oof. Got the two basics down. We draw an Uro. That's good. Uro is good. Outburst, Cascade, grab a Tybalt, make a Tybalt. I think we have to kill Phantasms, which is so strange. Sticking up, he just dies next turn anyway. So let's exile a Phantasm. I guess we can Glimpse plus Phantasm to put 10 in their graveyard and have a Phantasm in play as a 5/5. That certainly is a line. Oh dear. We should have one card for the mill matchup. Should have one card. Or it's not just for the mill matchup. One card on our side, but that allows us to like reshuffle our library. So that if we lose all three Tybalts, because now we're Tybaltless. We're on the Uro Omnath plan. That is all we've got. Well, that and these cards that Tybalt has drawn us. Can't really complain there, I guess. Gemstone Caverns. So Sanctuary. Put Cryptic on top of my library. Say yes. Green, white, and blue. Uro. Gain 3 life. Draw the Cryptic. Put a Gemstone Caverns into play. Glimpse them. Play a Jace, play a Phantasm, sorry. Okay, we got a 5/5 to trade with your 5/5. Problem is the Lurrus. Hopefully they put Lurrus in hand now and then we can keep up Cryptic Command to stop them from like casting it and resolving it. Because look at all the crabs and Phantasms in their bin. They have 3 cards in hand. What on earth could they have? Force of Negation, perhaps? They've got another push. That's interesting. Okay. So push my Phantasm. My Fandabadoozy. Ruin Crab. Okay. Hit us for 5. With the Uro on its way, the life total isn't the important bit. It's us getting mailed out by this Ruin Crab. Although, to be honest, there are only 6 cards less than us in library at the moment, so they haven't been doing very good with the whole mill plan. Draw a Tarns. We got blue. We got... I Because we just played the Uro, right? There's no reason not... Well, hang on. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7... If we play the Cryptic... Blue, blue, colourless, and blue. Can I go... Got green. Green. Blue and blue. We can't keep up Cryptic. That is rough. Let's get rid of these Tarns. We'll have Cryptic afterwards because of the Tarn coming in. But if they're counter magic, like Drown the Lock. But I guess you don't want to use it on Uro if you can help it. Gain 3 life, draw a card, put a land into play. Cool. We now have access to Cryptic in theory. I assume we have a fetchable blue source in our deck. Uro's got stuck with a bug. He's got a target on his head. Both Omnaths are in the bin, by the way. So our plan is Uro, Simeon, Beatdown. And our Field of the Dead is also in the bin now, so we don't have that either. They crack their Misty. I don't want to count something here if I can help it, because Lurrus is a problem with all the Phantasms that are in the bin. Melissa again. Push my Uro. See if I can find a blue source first. I can. Okay. Sanctuary. Put Dismember back on top. And then we're going to go Cryptic. We're going to go counter target spell, draw a card. Counter target spell, tap all creatures opponent controls. There we go. That's what we're going to do. Because we're going to draw the card off the Uro attacking anyway and have access to Dismember. They have Drowned the Lock. This is fine. It's not ideal, but it's fine. You get to hit us for 5 here. Go to 9. Draw the Dismember. Cast the Uro again. So green. No, don't want to do that. Green, blue, blue, and green. Getting rid of lands. Making their mill plan better. Cast this monkey. Oh, it's funny. It's funny. And pass to our opponent. If we dismember the Jesus Phantasm, they put the Lurrus into hand 100%, right? That is what they do. Attack me for 5. I'm going to try and kill it. Take 4 and kill it. Okay. Mesmeric Orb. Does that kill us? I think that probably kills us, right? It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yep. Well, we only go to 10 cards in library. We lose 2 for attacking. We draw an arrow. Gain 3, draw 1, lose 2. No land. We had to brazen borrow the Mesmeric Orb. That's pretty good. They block the Simeon. They take 6 and go to 8. Then we're gonna go ardent plea. Okay, there we go. It's two attacks in the air with my Brazen Borrower. They mill a load of cards. They draw one card. They mill us for three, which changes it. I can't just bounce the crab here and then attack them for eight on the ground. They put Luris into hand. Bounce the orb. Cast the fairy. Untap. Draw for turn. Steam vents. Okay. We just died the orb anyway for a tower with everything, right? So we need a way to kill them here, which is killing this rune crab. And I don't know if we've got anything left in our deck, honestly. Teferi, I guess. Just want to keep this one. They block the 6/6 here and only take 5. We need to just Teferi this. Choose a land to put into play. This one. We'll pay 2 life. I'm gonna 3. We can 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Play a strand. Crack a strand. Look at the top 3 cards in my library. Brazen Borrower, Force Negation, and Uro. Okay. So I need to go, keeping a blue up, I need to go green, green, blue, blue, and hope to God that we draw the Brazen Borrower for the win. Keep this one. Please, 1 in 3 chance. 33% chance. Actually, no, we've got 2 draws here, right? Okay. Go to combat and attack with everything. Trigger. 50% chance to draw the Brazen Borrower in our deck. We did. Hold control. Don't go to blocks yet. Petty Theft this bad boy back to the hand. God, what a game. What a game. Woof! That was tight. Kill him. Okay. Let's go to sideboarding. Do we want Ravenous Traps against them? No. We do want Mystical Disputes? Definitely. Do you want Dismembers? Probably. Trim to Fairies. Trim Force of Negations? I'm going to trim an Ardent Plea in favor of Teferi because... Oh, I've got too many cards in my deck. Because if they're milling us, there's a chance we have that situation again where we just... Our Cascade spells are dead draws at that point. I'm wondering if I should cut more to keep Teferis in. We're down to 6 cascading spells. Because we can't rely on it, it seems. Whilst we can't rely on it, I'm not a big fan of this hand. I'm going to mulligan this. Let's keep this. Let's bottom... this. Okay. We've got a Force Negation against something scary like the orb. An early orb is bad for us. And we want a Valky, right? We want a Valky their crab away and maybe mill them out. I don't know. Untap and draw. Simeon Spirit Guide. Okay. Let's go Misty Rainforest. Portmouth Forces, that would have to force and pitch our own Mystical Dispute. I'd much rather hit their Ruined Crab or whatever this is with a Mystical Dispute. Let's go crack this. I'm going to dispute that crab because crabs are good. They miss a land drop here? No. They were waiting. They were trying to play a crab and make a land drop. That makes perfect sense. Now they play a Phantasm. Just milled Mystical Dispute and Ardent Plea. That's fine. Uro, Violent Outburst and Flooded Strand into the bin. We untap and we draw. A Field of the Dead. We're going to shock ourselves and play a Valky. Looking at their hand, they have four cards in hand. They have Trophy, Glimpse, and Visions. Okay. We're two turns and a necessary land drop away from actually casting the Uro out of our bin. They play a second crab they just drew. That is pretty hot. They play Darkslick Shores. They mill us, and we now have 14 in graveyard. We're six off them being able to draw three off their Visions. We drew a Strand. Not terrible. This gives us an Uro next turn. Might grab a Steam Vents here anyway. So we've got double blue. We just need one more green source of our Scaldon Tarn. What kind of Scaldon Tarn grab? Can't grab a Steam Vents off of that anyway because it's in the bin. I want to play the Simeon Spirit Guide, you see. You see? Ketria Triome. There we go. Whatever. Next turn we can actually Mystic back the Outburst back on top of our library. And then we can Outburst into a Tibalt and see if that gets us somewhere. I mean, they can Trophy our Tibalt. But they'll probably Trophy the Uro first. Glimpse us and draw three. Seems good. 25 in graveyard, 27 in library. They draw three and get a six in the grip. We only have four in our hand. So resource-wise, we're behind, and they're halfway towards their total, their end game plan. They haven't played a land this turn because it's turn four, so they'll draw three here and almost definitely play a land. Preferably not a fetch. Oh, they missed a land drop. Okay. What do we find off the top of our library? A forest. Okay, let's go Scalding Tarn. Crack it. We're going to go and grab a Mystic Sanctuary. This will put Violent Outburst on top of our library. We have one Valky still in our library. We're then going to go green, green, blue, blue. Exile lands because we can't use them for definite. One Valky in play, one Valky in the graveyard, one Valky in our library. Okay. Do they trophy the Uro here, leading us to have a Valky? Because we can just recast Uro, but I guess that does get us deep into our deck, because that's kind of their game plan. They have six cards in hand, one of which is Trophy, and they haven't put Lurrus in their hand yet. Lurrus is still in the companion Pokemon zone. They know that we're probably... They almost certainly have a... Maybe not. They probably know. They probably know from playing Mill and playing current modern that we play three Valky in this deck, right? It's kind of become like it's common knowledge. There's a chance you play a fourth. Maybe we should have a fourth on our sideboard for these situations, and that's probably not a bad shout, to be honest. And by situations, I don't mean just Mill. I mean decks that can also, like, you know, go toe to toe with stopping you having your Valkies. So blue mana, okay. Imagine ultimating a Tibalt without any cards in our graveyard. It'd be wonderful. Beautiful. Next time we get to untap and keep up Force of Negation as well, which is a big one. Hedron Crab. Okay. Land drop. No. I'm just going to Trophy the Uro. Trophy the Ketria Triome. Okay. Say yes. Takes us off red. That's clever. What they don't know is that we have a Simian Spirit Guide in hand I couldn't cast earlier. Okay, cool. And we drew the Ardent Plea. Okay, let's go exile Simian Spirit Guide, make a Violent Outburst. Cast the Tibalt. Resolves. We're then going to exile Tarkuji. We're going to exile a Rune Crab. We're going to cast the Rune Crab. We're going to go to combat and attack. Why is my Valkia 3-1? Oh, because of the spell I just cast. Sweet. In we go. No land to put in. You just take 10 here. Okay. I'm cool with it. We have 21 cards left in our library. We have Force Negation up. They hit a land. Mills us for 6, down to 15. We have the counterspell for the orb. The orb is a rough one. They go double orb. But we know they didn't have orb earlier, so they've just drawn two orbs. Mesmeric Orb is bad for us here. Mesmeric Orb. I might just hard cast this, to be honest. I don't think pitching a card is right here, considering the circumstance. Like, keeping blue cards in hand for other forces off top of our library or their library, thanks to thingy, would be... Okay, Jace's Phantasm, sure. There ends our Tibalt. Two Phantasms. Interesting. This game continues to be interesting. What do we draw? Brazen Borrower. Tick up our Tibalt. Find a Omnath. Okay, let's play Omnath. And red here. Okay. Draw a card. Polluted Delta. Make a Zombo. Gain 4. Rune Crab them. Cool. Do I just cast an Uro to draw a card? Okay, crack this. Can we even get another land here? That's a question. We can. Pay 2 life. Make 4 mana. Make a Zombo. Ruin Crab them. We do get to 4 them post-combat thanks to the Uro trigger. Make a zombie. Cool. We're going to cast this Uro in hand and make sure that we don't accidentally keep it. Uro comes down. Keep this one. Trigger these around like this. Draw a card. Put a strand into play. Make a Zombo. Shoot them for 4. Okay. Okay. Let's go to combat attack. With an Uro. And not the Valkyrie. They block it at the 0-3, so it doesn't matter. Trigger from the Uro. Say done. Oh no, if this could fetch a land. What's possibly left in our library? We've got our basic forest. Have we got a basic island left? Nope. Let's just put it in case we need to go fetching. Rune crab them. Sure. We just kill a phantasm here. That's fine. We keep up Brazen Borrower in case of Mesmeric Orb. We are dead to an Archive Trap. We are dead to a Glimpse the Unthinkable. In all fairness as well. I mean, we have a Cryptic Command in hand, but I don't think we have another fetchable land. That's the problem we have here. I'll go fetching if we need to. So in response to like a game-winning spell, we're going to go have a look for another land. Fun. This is fun. I don't think this should always be the way modern is, but this is fun. Like, yeah, it's fun. Snapcaster Mage. Glimpse me. I'm gonna lose this game. Okay, let's go ahead and crack the Felidrand. And fail the final land. Yep, okay, there's not much I can do about that now, is there? Oh, they're gonna draw cards instead of milling me. They should have definitely flashback Glimpse the Unthinkable. With the first crab on the stack, I should have bounced a crab. Oh no. I had the win in hand. I had the win in hand. I could have bounced the crab and sent to the second third crab because we know then on 9 we're dead to. Yep. Whoopsie. There's probably a fetch somewhere along the line that I did wrong as well. They missed lethal, then got it anyway off the three cards. Okay. We got milled out. We're now another playing Snappies too. And with. Do we bring in Ravenous Trap? Do we bring in Ravenous Trap? Probably not. Force of Negation, though. I think I do bring that back in. I think Supreme Verdict to Wrath away phantoms and crabs. It's good. Fire spells can kill the crabs, but it can't kill the phantoms, so I don't think it's worth it. Good old Sultai 8 crab with Lurrus. Build your own Delver. Is this our longest round? I think this is our longest round by like a good 15 minutes. Right, we're gonna play first. We're gonna have a good hand. Come on. I want turn 2 combo with backup. That's what I was to ask. No, we can't keep this. Two counterspells and nothing else. This is Simeon's, Teferi's, Mysticals, and a Brazen Borrower. I'm gonna keep this and put one Simeon back. So we've got Mystical Dispute for their blue spells, like a crab. We've got Brazen Borrower for the Mesmeric Orb. Got Teferi from this miracle, but we're gonna keep this, put a spirit on the bottom, say done, and play a Skeleton Tarn. Pass the turn to our opponent. We can grab a Torium in the end step, or we can use it to get a blue source to Mystical Dispute a crab. I don't think I Mystical Dispute a Phantasm. I do Mystical Dispute a crab. Crabs are good. They will get us milled by, like, easily 15. Well, I say 15. Yeah, with 30, that's easily 15 over the course of a game. We're going to go and get a Steam Vents. No, we'll get a... Hallow Fountain? Yeah, Hallow Fountain. There we go. That's one crab down, baby. We untap and we draw a Misty Rain, Skeleton Tarn. I guess I might just get my Teferi ticking up. The more bounces I can get off Teferi here, the better. Let's grab a red source. Pay the life. Red. Oh, undo. Blue, white, red. Look, I don't think this is great, but... Okay. They have six Skeleton Hands, we have two. We have an active Teferi, so they can't Archive Trap us when we Skeleton Tarn. They can't Drown and Lock our spells. I guess we want to draw an Uro. Jace's Phantasm, sure. So we can bounce one, bounce the other. Love life. What do we draw? Cryptic Command. Sure. Bounce a Phantasm. Draw Force Invocation. Cool. Yeah, that's fine. If only Brazen Borrow was a 3-2, that'd be so good, wouldn't it? It'd be too good. Ruin Crab? Sure. Land Milos? Yeah, sure. Hit Valky and an Omnath and a Violent Outburst. Not what we want to see. Attack Jace. We're going to protect him here because we can get him back up to 3 next turn, which is another card drawn. I'm going to stop saying Triome names now. Just that I'm going to play a Triome. Like, I'm going to go get a Triome that makes green. No, end step, we fetch. Love to draw land here. Yeah, baby. There we go. Got access to Cryptic. Uptick. Not going to lie, we are struggling to kill our opponent in the next 5 minutes at this rate. We really need to get a Tibble, then get some Phantasms and mill them. Oh, resolve an Uro. They're up to 4 mana. They shock themselves. They crab us. We're going to fog them now. Tap Orcish Total Player controls and draw a card. Tap Orcish's opponent's control, should I say. Just Truth My Teferi? Is that what it is? Yeah, sure. Say yes, grab a snow-covered island. Draw an Omnath, draw a Violent Outburst, draw any of these things. Draw an Uro. Uro, Omnath, Teferi, meh. A redraw is a redraw. The Archive trap us here in main phase because we searched. Looks like we're not drawing an Omnath now because we just milled one. Even Tibble's not really that good here anymore. And we draw a Felistrand. Okay. Got an Uro in our bin. Got a green mana. Let's go crack this. Grab a Breeding Pool if there is one. There is one. Yeah, we're shocking ourselves here. We're shocking ourselves. It's shocking how much we're shocking ourselves. Uro, getting rid of Tarn, Floodstrand, Field of the Dead. Oh, we've lost our Field of the Dead as well. XR5. Draw a card, put a taunt into play. We can make a Brazen Borrower here. They're attacking for 10. We have to block one of them. Ruin Krabas, yeah. There are three Valkyries in our bin, so our Cascade Plan is now offline. That deck does seem pretty good against ours. This Tarn might not be able to find a blue source. The other problem of playing face lands against Mill. Oh no. Oh no. Take 10, go to 2. We're dying to like strictly better Delver. Strictly better Delver. In the abstract memories of the Aquati, Jace found interesting ideas to improve upon. Oh, is that that place where there's a little jellyfish and Narcomoebas from? Okay, so they trophy us. We're going to say yes. We're going to grab a forest. We're going to get archive trapped. No, we're good. We're good. Untapped. So we've got one blocker for the phantasms. Okay. Let's go ahead and cast a... Nope. An Uro. Nope. Want to use blue there, Vince. Getting this, 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 and this. Drawing a card. Draw a Gemstone Caverns. I just don't think it's going to cut it, my friends. I just don't think it's going to cut it. Okay, we're on 5. We can play a blocker. And then die. So we went 3-2. I felt like we were very in for a 4-1. I guess the metagame's shifting a bit and people playing things that are good against us. They attack with both. They saw the line. They saw the line, you see. They saw the line. I think this deck is very, very good. I think it's probably too good. I think the metagame has been skewed around it. Maybe it'll become the norm. And Wizards are okay with that in Modern. I'd rather it didn't, honestly. I think if you're more competent with it and the game than I am, then you will just win a lot. Both this and the Jund version. The Jund version, I think, has an advantage because it has Blood Moon to ruin the absolutely terrible mana base that this deck has. And it also has Valky to go and exile your Uros from your hand and then, like, 3 mana activate them and hit you. And, yeah, it's the better Valky deck because it has better black sources. I hope you enjoyed the video. Don't forget to hit that like button. If you liked the cut of my jib, then check me out on youtube.com/pleasantkenobi. And I'll see you all soon. Don't forget to use the code Kenobi when at checkout at channelfireball.com.